This is old Cam.
And this is not a spring chicken. Today we're going to be talking about Living Green.
Living Green.
Now here's one of the people we've had the pleasure to meet as well as to interview.
Many times.
Which is Ed Bagley Jr.
Yeah. I had the pleasure of meeting his father and working with his father, so it shows you how old I am, folks, because Mr. Bagley's in his 50s.
And this is one of the things, Ed Bagley did this. This is the Beverly Hills Times that I just picked up at the MTV VMA gifting suite.
Yeah. Yes. To put it
just a couple days ago.
In perspective, Mr. Bagley is a hands-on green person. Mm-hmm. He doesn't basically recommend something unless he's actually done it and put his wife through the misery of it.
Oh, Rochelle is so funny. The interaction between us two.
Yeah.
I mean, and you hear her talk. Actually, because I interviewed her. She's hilarious.
I think she doesn't care what he does as long as she has hot water.
Well, I can understand that.
Yeah.
You know, continuous hot water.
Continuous hot water.
For at least 5 minutes.
Right, like
one of the quotes that he has on here, which we always thought was really good, which he says, live simply so others may simply live.
Problem though, sometimes living simply, okay, I mean, I have a bone to pick with the Green Channel because their ideas of living simply are if you can go to the bank and you own the bank, you can be green on the Green Channel. For Mr. Bagley, he basically, we're talking, this is sort of he's an Irishman, folks, and he does not believe in putting the money under, so he does things himself.
Well, on his things, these are a lot of practical things that everybody can do.
Yeah.
That's why I always liked what he was suggesting.
Yeah, we did a video on him while we were at the
EMA,
Electronic Merchants Association, where he gave, you know, I think five things that you could do that didn't cost you any money to do, which is what more people should be doing. I think he's got a list
got a list of 10. It's his to-do list for Living Green. So, Ed, thank you very much. Number one is light bulbs, which says replace normal light bulbs with compact fluorescent.
Which I hate. I am constantly replacing compact fluorescent lights.
Tell them why you hate it.
They don't fit in the light holders because, a lot of light holders have shades on them. They won't screw into the thing.
And they screw up lighting for high-def cameras.
Oh,
but other than that.
Other than that, I love them. You know, they're more expensive. I spend more money on them, and they don't fit.
And for some reason, they're not lasting you nearly as long as they should be.
No, that basically, they count those lights like the Edison light that's in the firehouse that's been for 100 years. A light that lasts forever is counted in with the lights that don't last 10 seconds.
Yeah. Number two, energy-saving thermostats. For $100, you can save a lot on the energy.
Well, actually, we did that on yours for a lot less than $100, remember?
Yep.
I mean, it was a simple matter. We went to the hardware store. We'll plug Home Depot, folks. We got the...
Lowe's.
I think we got it. Either Home Depot or Lowe's, we got it. We simply unscrewed. I mean, it's a screw-on plate on a wall where your thermostat is. You unscrew it. You simply put the wires where the other wires were.
Yeah.
And then you put it back on the wall, and it's an energy saving. What was that, $19, $20?
Well, it's pretty easy. Actually, you know what they don't have on here, which kind of goes with thermostats, is I'll say fans.
Yeah.
Because sometimes it's too hot or too cold, and sometimes just getting the air moving.
Yeah.
Although, I guess you use electricity.
Yeah, use electricity, but you can, you know, okay, to get
put on a sweater during the winter.
here's a tip that you shouldn't use. This is a construction tip. If you want to move air quickly through a house, open a few windows in it when you turn the air conditioning on, and it sucks all of the cold air towards those things, and then it's going, so then you shut the windows down. You've already circulated real quickly.
Or also, when you're opening your windows for your house to get air, get a cross breeze.
Yeah.
You open up the windows so you can get a cross breeze.
That's right. But
so
this
the
is
air
just
will
on
move
this
through
is
the
just
house.
On how to save when you got an air conditioner or something on, because you spend a lot of energy trying to get everything all throughout the house at one time, but all you gotta do is open a few windows and it sucks it just like a vacuum.
Oh, that's easy then.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Fans could help too. Number three is extra insulation.
That's always smart. No matter we'll go to Nana Spring Chick's home where the insulation is below the top of the rafters in the ceiling. It's supposed to be, you shouldn't see the 2x4, the 4x4s and 4x6s up there. They should be covered in insulation. And if possible, if you can, insulate your roof tube with bats. Which is,
bat? Yeah, no, but they fly around.
No, basically, it's things you can go get. You can buy rolls of insulation you can put up into the rafters, and it helps to keep the air from going out to the top. So it's one thing if you have the, you know, your ceiling, I mean the roof, you know, the roof area covered, but you also want to cover the area that goes direct contact with the outside world, where you lose most of your heat is right through the roof of your house. It's a simple procedure. Most people can do it. You know, it basically, it just takes a long pants, a mask, long sleeve shirt, and a sharp cutting tool. And you just simply can put it up like that, and then you staple it in, and it's done.
Really?
Yeah, it's a simple it's a good family project. It's inexpensive and fast to do.
Number four, double pane windows.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
You know, every time, okay, anybody that's got kids knows about replacing windows. What you do is every time one of them breaks a window out, you put a double pane window in its place.
Or if you're changing them.
If you're going to do, if you're going to do work on your house, this is the time that you want to put these in. You basically don't want to cut your house up to put double pane in, because that's, you know, once again, it's called bring money.
Well, also, you know, if you're changing out your windows, if you have one whole side of the house, if the windows look different, it might be wise to change out all the windows on the one side of the house so they're consistent.
That's right. But or if you have a plan, you know, for instance, if you're a handyman, which I used to change things on places that we owned, one window at a time.
Really? That's if they look the same, right?
Yeah.
Because if they look different.
Well, no, but it's not meant to be a plug, but we used to use Anderson windows in projects that we did. Okay. Because Anderson had a large variety, so what we would do is keep the same general, we would go to the catalogs, keep the same general style, but not necessarily replace them all at the same time.
Right, but they're all similar. Yeah.
All similar.
Okay. Number five, energy efficient refrigerators.
Okay. Anybody that doesn't buy an Energy Star appliance when they have to replace deserves to pay the higher cost of it, because they're everywhere.
And it says that a refrigerator uses 25% of the energy in most homes.
That's right, because it's got that fanning of the door problem.
Oh, really?
That's right. You know, because, okay, it's every kid growing up, mother, you know, don't fan the refrigerator door. You know, but
isn't that why they put the ice things in the door
But see, not all doors have ice things in them, because of the simple fact that the water supply may be too far away from the refrigerator to put it. So kids being kids will simply open the door to get the...
Something like that? Open and close the doors?
That's right.
Energy efficient washer and dryer.
Which is another thing. There is no excuse for buying a washer and dryer that is an Energy Star, because they will save you money. Also, I think in a lot of cases you can get bigger loads in the energy, more energy efficient than you could in the other ones.
Oh, actually, here's one I did think about is because we got this great washer and dryer but they load from the front. So if you load, now I noticed one thing, when you load from the front, you can't put on there that it's a small load. If you load from the top, you can put that it's a small load.
That's right. You're stuck. You know, basically, front loading dryers and washing machines aren't really as efficient as a top loader.
Yeah, because the top loader, you could put that, you had a smaller load.
That's
you know
right.
what I mean?
Cause
it sometimes
is because
you don't have
sometimes you don't want to do you know, big things, because you've only, let's say they got a whole bunch of delicate things like swimsuits. You know, they're not very big. You don't need to put them.
And you want to wash them separately, and you just want it quickly done.
So you need a small load, and you can do that with a top loader. You really can't with a front loader.
Number seven, save water.
Yeah, okay. Take showers together. No, a lot of it has to do, too, with the fact that every person in our country overuses water to go to the toilet, to take baths, to take showers. Basically,
to brush your teeth.
Okay.
You don't like turn off the water when you're not brushing your teeth.
That's right.
You know, oh, actually, you know what I mean.
Okay.
In between when you're brushing.
Yeah, it's just like, okay, I know, and one of the things I do to save water is, like, you know, I also have an electric shaver, but I use a, you know, I tend to forget the electric shaver to go on things and go out to events. I sit there and have a cup, and I sit there and put my razor in the cup of hot water and just let it sit there, and then basically it's already ready to go anytime I want to go shaving. Then instead of running it under the tap to get it warm, you know, get it wet.
Here's another way to save on the water is don't use too much toilet paper, because then you don't have to flush it for as long.
Yeah. Okay.